people have said to me, Daniel, I wish Filmora had some audio effects. And to that I say, hello.
What are you talking about?
Filmora has plenty of audio effects, right, guys?
Right, we love Filmora. Sure do. You said it.
Filmora could make you sound like one of the greatest singers of all time.
Is this the real life?
Stick around, I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
Filmora 9 does not have specific effect inserts, so let me show you what I did. I recorded the footage of myself speaking and brought that into Filmora 9. I brought my footage down into the timeline, right-clicked on it, and detached the audio, so now it's on a separate track from the video. The great thing about this version of Filmora is that it allows you to add dozens of tracks. I added several additional audio tracks to work with. Next, I just had to find the sections that I wanted to put an effect on. For the echoing hello portion, I isolated that section by putting a slice before it and after it. Then I right-clicked on that section and copied it over to my clipboard. I scrolled down, highlighted the next audio track below it, and pasted it into that track. Be aware that the new audio will paste wherever the playhead is at, so make sure it's lined up with the original track. I repeated that process a few times, and now I had multiple copies of my audio. 5 or 6 seemed to work pretty well for me here. Here's where the fun begins. I took each clip, one at a time, and I moved them slightly to the right so that they started playing just after the original track. This is exactly how you create the delay effect. You'll want to stagger each one so that it starts after the previous. The more you spread them out, the longer the delay will be. Now, to make it sound like a real delay fading off into the distance, you'll want to click on each clip and slowly set the volume of each to be slightly less than the previous. I used increments of -5 for each one. I also used Filmora's custom equalizer setting to roll off the high and low frequencies of each one because I didn't want them all overpowering the main vocal. I put those all together and...
hello!
For this next creepy demon voice effect, I also copied and pasted the audio track, but I only made 2 copies this time. I didn't stagger the duplicate tracks. What I did instead was to change the pitch of each one. One of them I dropped down to sound lower, and the other one I raised up to make the pitch higher. I mixed the volume levels to where I liked them, and that gave me this final result.
What are you talking about?
That was also exactly how I did these sort of Alvin and the Chipmunk voices too. The only difference here was I increased the playback speed of those clips so that they were not only higher pitched, but they also played a little faster. That gave them a little more of that familiar Chipmunk sound.
Right, we love Filmora. Sure do, you said it.
Last but not least is the Freddie Mercury Harmonizer effect. This again uses the copy and paste track method, and we changed the pitch of the line I sang. The difference here is that I actually changed the pitch to a very specific note. A few of them were higher, and a few of them were lower. But when I put them all together, it sounded like a bunch of voices singing together in harmony. Some of the tracks I pushed back by 1 frame segment. That allowed the vocals to have a little bit of separation. I also used the equalizer again to tweak each track so that they sounded a bit more natural as the pitch was raised and lowered, and that gave me the overall harmonizer effect that I wanted.
Is